Hey, Mike, I've got a couple examples that I wanted to show them from this past slide you were just on. Yeah, can you transfer over the screen to me real quick?
Absolutely.
Okay, so I had a couple examples that I wanted to show you guys. Those of you that were with us on module one, you saw that I found a product using Black Box over at AmazonRankBooster.com. And the product was a portable blood pressure monitor. And you saw that I sent out quotes through Alibaba so that I could get some initial pricing. And then after I did that, I also reached out to our team in China and got a quote from them. So I just kind of wanted to show you guys what that process looks like, what the quotes look like. And then I also am going to take the price that I received from our team in China and put it into the product sourcing calculator and just kind of show you what the current net margin looks like. So let me go over to Alibaba right now. Hold on one second.
Hey, it's Mike here, and we just launched version 7 of our Amazon training course, where we walk you through the process of how we sold just in the last 30 days, our first 30 days, over 1,000 products with the brand new ranking strategies that we're now showing to the public. We've trained over 1,000 students, and last year alone, we did over $3.2 million online. And if you go to my site, put your credit card away, enter just your first name and your email address, I'll immediately send you a series of free training videos that walk you through the process.
See, guys, like, and these are like real examples, right? So, like, it's one thing to tell you what to do, but if we don't show you how to do it, like, what's the value, right? So, the
Yep.
key here is like, Mike is showing you actual examples of stuff from our last week, right? Like, that's what's amazing is that, like, you guys aren't just seeing like what to do, but you're actually seeing like how to do it. Like it's like everybody loves to eat sausage, but some people don't like want to know how the sausage is made. Like you guys are learning like not just that the sausage is delicious, but like how it's actually made, right?
Yeah, exactly, Mike. So, guys, check this out. So, when we talked on the webinar, when we were going through the process of sending out the request for quotes, I had mentioned on that webinar that one of the keys to getting quotes back from Alibaba that actually made sense, right? Like quotes that where the people actually answered your questions. It was really, really important to use that template that I showed you. And I also mentioned that it was a numbers game, right? You're not going to send out two quote requests and think you're going to get the perfect quote back. It honestly is a numbers game on Alibaba. And that's one of the key reasons why we love using our team in China, because they do all this manual work for you. Like you literally have to send out 20, 25, 30 quote requests to get maybe three or four quotes back that actually make sense, that actually have answered your questions properly. It's just the way it works. And I'm going to show you guys in real time exactly what I'm talking about. So I sent out roughly 30 quote requests for this portable blood pressure monitor, and you can see them all right here. I mean, literally, I sent out 30 quote requests because I know from experience that if I wouldn't have done this, I would have gotten, I would have gotten only a couple of back, a couple quotes back if I would have sent out, two or three quotes. And there's a very high percentage chance that none of them would have made sense. That my questions wouldn't have been answered. I would not have had any data to go on. And when you're looking for a product, you want things to happen quickly, right? So you've got to, these types of strategies that we're going over now, especially this type of strategy on Alibaba, just remember that it's a numbers game. You can't send out just two quote requests and think you're going to get back any kind of usable data. So with that said, you can see how many quotes I sent out. So I got a couple of that. Actually, out of 30 quote requests, I only got two back that actually were any good. So that just shows you, the ratio of how many you have to send out to how many you actually get back that will work for you. So this is one that I got back that I really, really liked. And I double checked. I made sure this company was a gold supplier, which they are. I made sure they were part of Trade Assurance, which they are, because that's really important. But as you can see here, I got a good quote back. This person answered all my questions perfectly from, remember guys, this is the template I used, right? And this template's in the membership area under downloadable resources, just for those of you that might have missed that information. It's called the manufacturer outreach letter. And this is exactly what it looks like. And then you actually get back the information that you request, right? So I got, you know, the price per unit back for the amount of units I asked for. And they actually didn't answer my questions perfectly, because I asked for the MOQ 500 and 1,000 units, and they only gave me back, you know, the price for 1,000 units here. So again, you know, you really have to pick and choose these manufacturers on Alibaba, because most of the time they do not answer your questions the first time. But I felt like this one was a good enough one to, you know, show the example. So again, I got my price per unit. I got my DDP shipping costs, which is extremely important. For those of you that don't know what that means, definitely check out module one in the membership area. I go through exactly what that means. It's very important that you ask for that type of shipping quote. So I got the cost per unit for shipping. I got the cost per unit for the actual product. I got the lead time, 20 to 30 days, which is good. So I felt pretty comfortable showing you this quote. Also, they sent me it in a PDF and an Excel format. And actually the PDF copy that they sent me looked like this, and I'm gonna scroll in on this. So the PDF copy was really nice. And sometimes you will run across a manufacturer on Alibaba that will actually give you a very detailed quote like this. But this is the blood pressure monitor that I wanted the quote on. And then they give you all the features and specs on it as well. And as you can see here, the MOQ is 1,000 units. And that's the price point that you just saw right over here in this section, right? So, you know, I felt comfortable, again, sharing this example, because this manufacturer actually gave me a detailed price quote back. So this is what you should expect. I mean, really, you should expect something along these lines here. You should expect to get something like this back as well, because again, you want as much detail as possible. So I took that into consideration. And then, like I said, I also asked my representative, well, not my representative, but our representative at Jing for a quote on a similar product. So let me show you what I got back from them. So they always send detailed quotes. So this is what a quote looks like from our team in China. Again, like we talked about on the last webinar, their name is Jing Sourcing. And I, you know, you're able to communicate with your representative at Jing as well. So if you get your quote back and you have specific questions about it, you can contact them through an app called WeChat. And if you don't have WeChat on your, you know, your smartphone or your tablet, all you have to do is go into wherever you get the apps from, download it, and then you just ask your Jing representative for their WeChat ID. And that's one of the easiest ways to communicate, because it's a two-way communication, just like you're texting someone. So I highly, highly recommend doing that. So yeah, this is, once you get your quote back, you'd review it. If you have any questions, I would contact them on WeChat. But I got, you know, I felt pretty comfortable with the quote I received. I negotiated on it. Obviously, you always want to negotiate. You know, if you get a price back from Alibaba, you get a price back from your Jing representative. These prices are negotiable, right? If you don't ask, you don't get. So you have to ask. They may come back to you and say, you know, we can only give you 5 cents off, but hey, 5 cents is better than nothing, right? You wouldn't have got it if you wouldn't have asked for it. So you always have to ask that question. You know, is there any, can you go any lower on the price, or is there any room in the price? Most of the time you'll get something off. So after negotiating with them, I got it to $850 a unit on 1,000 units, including custom packaging. There's a $35 sample fee, and I got the DDP shipping cost at $1,600 for 1,000 units. And then they also have their service fee that they charge for doing all this work for you. And this is just part of what they do for you, but they do charge a service fee. And for this particular product, at $8,500, you're looking at a 7.5% service fee. The fee is a their service fee is a sliding scale. So it depends on how much the dollar amount of the order is. That'll determine the service fee. If the order is higher, then the service fee is lower. If it's lower, then it's usually a little bit higher. But they've got their service fee right on their website. You can check it out. It shows exactly the different dollar amounts for the different service fee ranges. So with that said, I was at $8.50 a unit here on the quote I received from Jing. And then over here on Alibaba, let me get back there real quick. Hold on a minute.
Hey, it's Mike here, and we just launched version 7 of our Amazon training course, where we walk you through the process of how we sold, just in the last 30 days, our first 30 days, over 1,000 products with the brand new ranking strategies that we're now showing to the public. We've trained over 1,000 students, and last year alone, we did over $3.2 million online. And if you go to my site, put your credit card away, enter just your first name and your email address, I'll immediately send you a series of free training videos that walk you through the process.
I was at $8.72, which is a little bit higher, and then their shipping came in a little bit Jing's shipping came in a little bit lower as well. So based on all the research I did, based on all the quotes I looked through, I literally looked through all 30 of these quotes. I feel very comfortable after doing that research, and that's the same kind of research you should do as well. Just get familiar on how much the product's actually going to cost you, and you'll never know that until you go through and do all this research. So I feel pretty comfortable at this price, at $8.50, that I'm getting a fair price for this type of product. So as soon as I know what my fair price is, I'm going to take that over to the product sourcing calculator. And I showed you all this product sourcing calculator in module 1 as well. So once you get that price per unit that you think is fair, you want to bring it over here to the product sourcing calculator. So based on the $29.99 sale price that we came up with, based on looking at our competitors, making sure that's a competitive sale price, we started this process, and we were just kind of guesstimating. So, and we came up with a number of $6, and that's before we did any of that research, and that's before we asked for any quotes. That was just us basically looking at the product on Alibaba, just searching for it and seeing what people were selling it for. But after actually sending out the quote request, the price came in $2.50 higher. So as you can see, it's super, super important to ask for those quotes, because you would never want to just go on this first initial price point, right? Just by doing the searches. Because as you can see, this affects your margin, right? So it wouldn't be a smart business decision just to go on that first initial price you see when you're doing your research. That's not the way you do it. So like you just saw, we're at $8.50 a unit now. Also on the quote that Jink sent us, it was $1,600 at 1,000 units, so that's $1.60 per unit for shipping, and that's the DDP shipping cost. And then again, in the very beginning, we're right around $2 per unit on our ad spend. And then our FBA fee, which I showed you guys how to do as well in module 1, is $7.80. So that leaves us with a net profit of $10.09. So with very accurate numbers, we're still at a 34% margin, right? Which is good. We usually want to be somewhere between 30 and 50% margin. Obviously, if we're over 50%, then we're extremely happy. But somewhere between 30 and 50% is usually where we fall with our products. And we still have some room to bundle here as well, right? The fact that we're at a 34% margin, we could add in a couple of very, very inexpensive products cost-wise, still keep this same selling price, and still be at, I'm going to venture to say, around a 30% margin roughly. Or we can add some products in that might cost us a little bit, increase this price because we're offering a bundle that's worth more to the customer, and still make this 30% margin with no problem. I feel very confident about that. Because some of, if you remember, some of the products that we looked at for this portable blood pressure monitor were simpler type products. It was like a carrying case for the blood pressure monitor. It was an additional AC adapter for the blood pressure monitor. Those products are going to be very, very inexpensive. So I feel very confident that I could add that to, I could add a few dollars here to this price, and then add maybe $2 or $3 here and still be between a 30 to 35% margin with no problem. And maybe that's just because I've done this so many times, but I can tell you just by looking at the numbers that we would be safe. So yeah, that's exactly, you know, how you want to look at your quotes that you receive. And then you always want to make sure you do that research like I talked about. And then utilize our tools. Utilize the product sourcing calculator to make sure that, you know, you can move on to the next step, right? Because like we talked about again in module one, the next step from here would be to go into the 10-point checklist that Sam went over, right? There's different sections of this entire process, right? There's the initial research section through Black Box. Then there's the quote request section that you have to go through. Then there's the research section within Alibaba. Then there's putting the numbers in the product sourcing calculator to make sure that the product's, you know, viable at this step of the process. Then the next step of the process is the 10-point checklist. As you can see, we've done everything that we can possibly do to minimize the risk when you're launching a new product, you know, because from our many, many years of experience selling products online, selling products on Amazon, we've developed these strategies because we don't want any of our students to launch a product and, you know, have a failure. That's not our goal, right, at all. So we've developed all these strategies to help you as much as possible to not have a failure. Nothing's guaranteed, obviously, nothing's guaranteed, and we would never make that claim that you're gonna have a winner every single time you launch a product, because that's not true and nothing's guaranteed. But these strategies will help minimize your risk of having a failure. I can tell you, if you don't follow strategies when you're launching product on Amazon, the percentage of you failing and the percentage of you not having a successful product is very, very, very high. And I'm just telling you that from experience, going through it myself, making crazy mistakes and, you know, unfortunately having to close down listings because of those mistakes, but learning from them, coming out the other end stronger and implementing, you know, these strategies from the experience that we have in launching, you know, numerous successful products. So, Mike, that's everything I have, man. Let's jump back into the presentation. Hold on one second for me.
Yeah, for sure. That was a good job too, Mike.
Thanks, man. So yeah, that based on the slide here, you know, we talked about reviewing the initial pricing as it relates to the sourcing calculator, and we talked about, you know, and what we mean by this here, this might be a little bit misleading. First impression is always the best impression. What we're really talking about here is the first impression you get from when you reach out to a manufacturer, right, on Alibaba, or you reach out to our team in China. You're going to get, you know, it's like what I talked about, like you're going to get a feeling for a manufacturer if they answer your questions properly, right? We can tell you, our team in China, they're going to answer your questions properly because we've dealt with them for years. On Alibaba, that's not always the case. Like I said, you might send out 30 quote requests and get two back that make sense. So your first impression is always the best impression. Just keep that in mind when you're going through that process.
Yeah, and guys, always remember too, Alibaba, we use that for like baseline pricing, right? You, mm-hmm. Like one out of 20, you might actually find the right manufacturer, but remember, we're using Alibaba to get pricing.
Exactly. Yeah, it's always good to, like I said, it's good to do your research. It's good to understand what the product costs. So when you do get a viable quote from our team in China, then you understand that you're getting a very competitive price, right? I mean, you saw $8.50 from our team in China, $8.72 from the Alibaba quote, right? You can feel pretty confident that you're getting the most competitive price for the product because you're comparing apples to apples, right? If you only went with our team in China, you wouldn't have that knowledge of how much the product costs, right? Like what in the market, what does that product cost? You figure that out by getting those quotes from Alibaba. That's really important.
Yeah, because then the team in China, right? Like they'll get you a better price, but you also have the safety that they're going to verify quantity. They're going to verify quality. They're going to make sure that before your product goes to Amazon, right, that it's actually what you ordered based on quality, based on, you know, like verifying it's actually the amount you want to send, right? Like, you know, imagine like, and I'm not saying everyone at Alibaba is bad, but with that being said, if you're expecting 1,000 units, who's going to verify that it's actually 1,000 units? You want someone to actually verify it instead of just the guy in Alibaba saying, oh, we're going to send 1,000 units, right? Who's going to verify that except Amazon? And then it's too late.
Yep, exactly. Yeah, and it, like I said before, guys, too, if you don't already, if, you know, for those of you that are new, this is how you get in touch with Jing Sourcing. And if you go to Module 3 in our membership area, this link is there as well. But you would just click on this link and then you would fill in the information and you would get a representative assigned to you within roughly 24 hours. So I went over all that information in the last module, but yeah, that's exactly how you would get a rep assigned to you. And then like Mike said, they ensure the pricing and quality. And then this last bullet here is really important too. And this is something I mentioned when I was going through introducing Jing on the last webinar. But remember, your Jing representative, when you're going through the sampling process, they'll help you get multiple samples in one box and they'll send you all the samples at one time. And for those of you that are wondering why that's important is because it'll help you save a ton of money on shipping from China. Sometimes the shipping from China can actually cost more than the sample itself. So it's very important that you get all the samples that you want sent to your Jing representative. They'll put them in one box. They'll put one shipping label on it and send it out to you. You're only paying for shipping one time rather than five or six times, right? There's no need to waste money.
I've really felt like since I've joined, this is one of the best decisions I've made in my life.
From August 2nd to September 2nd, I generated 15,000 in sales.
I did about 6K one day.
We set a goal of 300 sales in the first 2 weeks, and we met that in 8 days.
Our first 12, 13 days, we've average just over $1,000 per day in revenue.
Right now I've got 74 five-star reviews, bestseller ranks at 29, and I've sold in 45 days almost 500 units.
We are moving about 15 to 20 units per day right now.
We were number one new release on Amazon within 24 hours.
So the last 12 months would have been in July, I reached I guess six figures.
I've seen the result and I've been very impressed.
Today actually is ironic that we're making this video because we hit our biggest numbers sales organically.
We still made 150% on our investment.
By far, the level of accountability you guys bring and support to your team is uncanny.
What you guys are teaching us changed my life.
Just mind-blowing and very helpful in helping us launch our products.
We were able to create an entire business from scratch with no knowledge before really of how to sell on Amazon.
It gave us basically a roadmap to get involved in e-commerce without having to reinvent a wheel.
If I didn't have this training to follow, I'm sure it would be very difficult for me to research everything and to come up with a process that would work.
The way Mike and Matt teach is really a foolproof method.
The quality and integrity of the program is amazing. The clarity of instruction, and the detail of instruction is really easy to follow along.
I've been amazed with how robust and how much information they have in their program.
I get so much information from the training videos and it's incredible.
Love the modules that I can listen to them again and again.
the steps that are laid out are very much succinct and something that you can follow.
It really is good to just consistently go over and over and over the same, the basics in order to get your business up and running.
Everything that you've taught me so far has been useful. I've used a number of it, both in this side business and also at my day job.
You guys been helping me out with the Voxer talks, the live training videos that you guys have been sending me.
Learning that this even exists, learning the process of how to be successful has really been great.
I like how the information can be applied to other businesses, other online ventures that you might want to do.
We love this business for the business model.
I'm just so excited to be selling online and making money in a way that I never thought I would.
I'm just excited to get this started.
If you want free time and you know how this passive income system can work, I think you'll see the same thing.
Ultimately, pour into the things that I love. And for me personally, that's my family.
I'm just grateful for you guys. I feel like you're super positive.
One of the things that you guys do is set the tone for giving everything you've got.
You go above and beyond.
They aim to overdeliver. They don't need to do as much as they do, but they do it anyway.
Mike and Matt are just regular people. Successful, but willing to share the knowledge and help us become successful too.